Today, you are going to learn exactly how to use the EveryDollar app by Dave Ramsey so that you can budget super easily and gain better control over your money. The process of actually signing up for EveryDollar is pretty simple. You'll end up on a screen like this. So this is where we're gonna be spending most of our time. This is our actual budget. We're gonna jump straight into planning out our first budget, and then we're gonna talk about how it actually works in practice. So for the sake of the example, let's say we make $5,000 a month and we receive two paychecks for that. Once we have our income set up, then we have $5,000 left to budget. What makes EveryDollar so unique is that it is a zero-based budget, which means the goal is to get this $5,000 down to zero. That way you know where all of your money is going. So you'll notice there's all these different groups. We have giving, savings, housing, goes on and on. Within giving, it has two defaults, church and charity. Let's say you want to give to your church $500. Below that, we have the savings group. And this is where you're going to encounter your first fund. This is a pretty neat feature built into the app. The way funds work, if you want to just click on it and hit fund details, you will see this little drop down, and you can go ahead and set a goal for your fund. For the sake of this example, let's say you want to have a 3-month emergency fund. That would come out to $15,000 if you want nothing at all to change about the way you spend your money. So that's our goal. Let's say we already have maybe $1,000 saved up towards that goal. We can hit save after that. Now you see that you have a remaining of $1,000, but we're not going to spend much time over here just yet. But what you can do is go ahead and input what you intend to give for this month. But let's say you want to put aside $500 towards your emergency fund. And it's not just the emergency fund. If you go ahead and hit add item, you can very easily create another fund for a vacation. And you can see that this is actually not a fund because it doesn't have this little piggy bank. What you want to do is hit it. And then over here, it'll say, make this a fund. Make this a fund, and it's the same thing. But since I am not currently planning a vacation, I'm just gonna go ahead and delete this. So for housing, let's just say we spend the average amount of $1,000 a month. On water, we spend 50. Natural gas, we spend another 50. Electricity, we spend 100. And cable, who watches TV? And trash, I actually have no idea what trash costs. We can just delete this one. For transportation, you can input your gas. Let's say that's $100 a month. And then maintenance, let's say your oil or blinker fluid costs $20 a month. Let's say, you know, you also like to get a car wash a couple times a month. You can add an item, car wash, and say it's another $20 a month. Moving down to food, we have groceries and restaurants. So let's say we spend $300 a month on groceries, and on restaurants, we want to budget $50. Moving right along, let's say $75 for clothing, your phone. Phone's pretty expensive. It's probably another $75 for fun money. You can put whatever you want to put there, $50. Hair and cosmetics. So you get a haircut this month, $25. Subscriptions, things like Netflix, Amazon, all comes out to $50 a month. And for lifestyle, let's say you have a pet and you have to get them groomed once a month, so you put $100 here. I find that this miscellaneous tab here is usually a good idea to put a little bit of money into. Let's say just $100. Under the health group, we have our gym. My gym is $40 a month. This month, we're not spending any money on medicine or vitamins or doctor visits, so we can keep on going. Let's just say, for example, you don't want a particular group. You can just hit delete group right over here, and boom, it's gone. If you're in debt, then this is definitely somewhere you want to allocate money to. Let's say you have $1,000 in credit card debt. You can put that right here. Every time that we add something to the plan, the money up here at the top is going down. So we're down to $795 and we're at the bottom of the page. So we have a little bit of extra money to work with. What we can go ahead and do is say, all right, well, let's put some more money towards the emergency fund. Let's do $750 towards the emergency fund, get that going a little bit quicker. And since we have a little bit of extra money, we can spend a little bit more on restaurants this month. And then we're gonna spend all of the rest of our money on car washes, because this is just an example video. All of our money is planned out, and you can see up here we have an EveryDollar budget now. We know where every one of our dollars is going. Now let's say something ends up costing more than we might have thought. Gym prices went up as they always do, and now we'll have a $10 over budget. So what we would need to do is go to another area and reduce the price. Say for clothing, we can reduce that to $65, and now it's back to an EveryDollar budget. And then another cool feature is for different items that you have a lot of transactions for, you can go ahead and click, and up here there's a star. You hit favorite, you go to the gas station a couple couple times a week, it makes sense to favorite it. You know, that you go to the grocery store a couple times a week as well, we could favorite that too. And we can also favorite, of course, the car wash. We're going at least 3 times a day. And then you'll see there's a new group here for favorites. Soon you'll find out why it's helpful to have those at the top. Now, you may have noticed that over here on this side, there's this really nice pie chart that just gives you a great understanding of how you plan to spend your money. That is the gist of how you would plan out your budget. What you'll notice is that all takes place on this column right here. And now we're going to talk about how every dollar functions in action, which takes place right here in this column. This side is where you're going to be spending most of your time. So when the time comes that you receive your first paycheck, up here at the top right, you hit transactions, and then you're going to hit add new. And this is not an expense, but it is our income. And we're going to hit $2,500. It is prompting us to inform where the money came from and choose the budget items. And if you hit paycheck one and then track income, you can see this green bar appears and we have received $2,500. Now, if we hit add new one more time and we don't tell them where the money came from and we hit track income, it'll appear right over here. And what you can do is just drag it onto paycheck two. And then you have another green bar indicating that you received all of it. If you only received 2,400, then the green bar will not fill up all the way. Moving right along to our favorites. Let's say today we spent $20 on gas, add new expense. And we also spent all of our money on our groceries, our entire budget. We decided to just buy it all in bulk. And we also spent $50 on car washes on this particular day. So it'll just populate right over here. All you gotta do from this point is just drag it onto the appropriate items. And you can see, get a general idea of how much you have left to spend by these bars here. Now let's say, for example, it turns out we actually forgot an ingredient at the grocery store and we need to buy something else. We run over and we spend $20 more at the grocery store. And so we add that to our groceries. You can see it's now red. That indicates that we've gone over the budget. And what needs to happen is we need to adjust our plan. And so we're gonna change the plan to $320. Now we're $20 over budget. All we need to do is take $20 from somewhere else. Perhaps maybe we can't eat out quite as often this month because we went over on our groceries. Now, once you've completed an entire month and it's time to make a new budget for August, you hit July and then move to the next one. You just say start planning for August. And what it will do is bring everything from July into August, all the groups and the items and the amounts of the items that you have planned out last month, and it brings them here. And so from here, all you would need to do is do a couple tweaks as every month changes, you know, a little bit here and there. And after about 3 months, you'll probably find a pretty good rhythm and you'll be able to actually plan accurately to what you end up spending. Now, there is a paid version of every dollar, and what it will do is actually automatically track your transactions with all of your accounts in one place, and it'll give you custom reports on your income and spending. I could really see that saving a lot of time. It is $129 a year and you can do a 15-day trial. I haven't done it yet, so I really can't speak much on it, but know that that exists and that is a really cool feature. If there's any questions that you have, please ask me in the comments. I reply to all of your comments. Smash that like button and subscribe for more financial content. Thank you.